Hi guys, welcome back to my channel once again. Thanks for stopping by. For a few days I was not able to upload any videos. I think you may be worried about why I'm not uploading, because I was not so well. I got cramp in my ankle, and energy was very much fluctuating. I was feeling low, sometimes very high. The energy was very fluctuating, so I was not in a condition to do a reading for divine feminines in twin flame or a twin flame reading. I hope you understand. Today I have a message for you. I have a message for you that karmics want to give you. A divine feminines, I know this is a very crucial period for all the divine feminines in this twin flame journey, and many of the divine feminines are also still now going through the dark night of the soul, because they have in a very recent time they have discovered that they are in this kind of spiritual journey, in this twin flame journey. And I can say, and many of the and other divine feminines also, and rest of the divine feminines who are in this twin flame journey, they're already awakened. They have gone through the dark night of the soul, and now they are rediscovering their own self again in 2020. They are getting back in their power. They are having their spiritual awakening. They're transforming themselves into a beautiful butterfly. They are becoming more courageous. They are no more stuck into the divine masculine's energy, though the divine masculine for few days trying to hold back divine feminines. They were literally sending sexual energies to divine feminines. I'm sure you guys can feel that that the divine masculine is doing so. The divine masculine is very much aware that the divine feminines, those divine feminines are awakened. Those twin flames are for, they have discovered, and the separation period is more than 2 years or 3 years, and they have discovered they are in a twin flame journey. And after all this dark night of the soul, the divine feminines, had done their inner work that they had to do in this process, and now they are rising like a phoenix bird out of the ashes. They are transforming into a beautiful butterfly, going through all the stages that a butterfly has to go through to become a beautiful mature butterfly. They have done all the inner work. That is the reason they are feeling more confident, more attractive. They are emanating positive vibes. And at the same point of time, those divine feminines who have awakened, those divine feminines who are in their spiritual awakening, I have message for them. Karmics want to communicate with you. Yes, guys, karmics, your divine masculine's karmic wants to communicate with you. They are literally, the karmics are very much envious of you. They envy you so much because they always want to copy you. They are a total copycat. They always try to imitate the divine feminists, how they look, how they present themselves, total facade. They just put on a facade like as if they are divine feminists, okay? But it's not that. And they are very much jealous of you. They know that you are better than them, and even they know that they are karmic in your divine masculine's life. Yes guys, karmics know they are the karmics in your divine masculine's life. It's not like that they love your divine masculine. No, it's not like that, but they want to keep your divine masculine. They want to hold your divine masculine because they don't want you to win. They don't want you to win. They want to hold the divine masculine to themselves, only for themselves, for financial reasons or any other reasons. It can be toxic reasons, whatever, to fulfill their own personal demands or personal needs. And karmics are telling that if anyhow divine masculine comes to you, they will take revenge from you. Yes, they are very much revengeful. They are very much in a vengeance. They are, you know, some of the divine masculines already got awakened, and they want to get free themselves from the karmics. And some of the divine feminines, divine masculines have also, you know, freed themselves from the karmics. They have launched a divorce file or something like that, that to get themselves free from the karmics. And the karmics are telling you that they want vengeance. They will not leave you. Yes, but you don't have to be worried so much about it. You don't have to be worried because Archangel Michael is protecting you very much. Archangel Michael is protecting all the divine feminines who are in this journey. You are very much spiritually protected by the divine, by the God. And when divine is protecting you, nobody can harm you. Trust me, nobody can harm you. But yes, at the same point of time, be aware, be very much cautious. Because, you know, when you are very much cautious about everything that is happening in your surroundings, you feel you're quite safe inside yourself. You are aware of everything what is going on surrounding you. And be aware of some of your friends. Maybe some of your friends are in contact with the karmics. Yes, karmics. They are backstabbing you. They are helping the karmics. And you know, karmics know about you, both of you, about your divine masculine feminine equation. They know that you are twin flames and something, some kind of sort like this. I think the karmics have tried everything, every procedure to manipulate divine masculine, to curb their emotions from their divine feminine. Because, you know, I think they are continuously putting, or they have tried doing any kind of black magic, black spells on their on your divine masculines, and even onto the divine feminine, so that divine feminines cannot, you know, cannot succeed in her life. She might suffer in her life all the time. She's so much jealous. Yes, divine feminists, I'm sure some of you have felt some sexual abuse in dreams. Yes, because the karmics are doing on black magics. I'm sure some of the divine feminines have gone through the phase where you have dreamt of you are being raped, or you are done something very bad, sexually done something bad to you, or something different kind of energies, bad energies you have felt that is going on. You have felt it not only once, maybe twice or thrice. And you know, when you came to know something bad is happening, or you are aware that somebody is doing black spell on you, dark spell on you, or magic on you, it be the, you know, the effect of that automatically decreases. The effect of that automatically decreases. You don't have to be aware of, as I have told you before also, that you need to call Archangel Michael for protection so that you can have a beautiful, wonderful sleep. In the sleep, when you are sleeping, your astral body, you have to protect your astral body so that nobody can do anything negative with your astral body. You know, this black magics and all, they can sometimes try to harm your, you know, not harm actually, they try to, you know, manipulate and do dirty things with your astral body. And you will not feel bad about it. It's not going to happen anything, but you will not feel bad, good about it. You're feeling what's going to happen, why it's, I'm feeling as if it's happening in real life. It happened to me in real life. Because whatever happens in our, with our astral body, we can feel it very much as if it has happened to us in a real life. So be aware of that. And you know, karmics are telling that they want a revenge. Even if you somehow came into union with your divine masculine, I'm sure they will somehow again try to come back to your divine masculine's life. Yes, I'm sure. I can say many of the divine masculines are married with their karmics and they have children. Child issues is going to affect your life, love life. And in that way, when you are connected with the children, whether you get divorced or not, you do have a connection with your previous partner. Though you have got divorced, still you have a connection somehow, because both of them are having a child together. And so that child will be an issue that they will try to come back into their life. into your divine masculine's life and try to manipulate them somehow. You know, they will make you, they will just like emotionally blackmail your masculines if they, again, after you came into union with your divine masculine. Yes, they will try to do this. Yes, definitely. Not because they want it, because of the reason they want you to lose. They don't want you to see happy. And at the same point of time, the karmics are in spiritual contact with some of the people who used to do all this, who are very much engaged in the spiritual stuffs, like they used to do all this spell works, then black magic or this tarot readings. They have done readings, guys. Yes, I'm sure some of the karmics are very much in contact with this kind of people who used to do all these readings, all these tantric things and all these things. They are in contact with those kind of person. They are paying huge amount of money, and they have put on many of the spells to hold on the divine masculine, but nothing is working. They are literally going more mad and crazy. Why it's not working? Still, they are putting on. They are never able to hold the divine masculine back. It is always like back and forth. Because, you know, as whatever they will try to do, as it is a divine connection, maybe the black spell can do one thing. What can it can do? It can delay the connection a little bit. But it's not like that. It's not going to happen. Whatever is destined to happen, whatever God has planned, nobody can change His plan. If you are destined to meet with your twin flame, it is going to happen at the right point of time. And why it's happening, all these things, you know, because this meant to happen, because both the divine masculine and feminine need to learn a lot through this process. Now see, divine feminine has learned a lot. She has become very much conscious of all the toxicity, all the negative thing that was she was carrying inside herself, and now she is releasing continuously all the toxic people, all the toxic thing that was surrounding her previously or right now. She is releasing all those patterns, all the toxic patterns, all the negative patterns that is no more serving her. And that is why it's happening, you know. And the most important thing is that karmic knows that this is a divine connection, and they are very much jealous to hear that it is a divine connection. I'm sure the person to whom they are going for readings and all this tarot readings or whatever tarot readings can be, or they it can be tantric or something like that with spiritual stuffs and all. I'm sure this karmics is very much jealous when they heard of that this is a twin flame connection, a connection that has to be that is very strong. Nobody can break it. It's destined to be like this, you know. So she got very much jealous and very much insecure, because she no more can hold your divine masculine back. And at the same point of time, it's not because of the love she wants to hold your divine masculine. No, for her personal codependency, for her personal needs, that is very much selfish. And this karmic is very much nasty, very much karmic in her patterns, very much narcissistic in her tendency. She is very ill-tempered, bad-tempered, don't have love in herself, because she don't have self-love. She is very much messy kind of things. She is not at all a housewife material. Who is very much well-decked and all. She's always in a messy mood. She's always in a very angry mood, very irritated mood. She's always very much concentrated about herself, and she doesn't know how to love a person. And this time, God, the karmics are getting readings. Yes, I can feel it very well. The karmics are getting readings about you, and some of the karmics are trying to peep on your social media through different accounts. Maybe you know some of the karmics personally. You know their what is the name of the karmic. You know them personally. And some of you may not know, but the karmics know you very well. They have seen your photographs, and because your divine masculine himself told her about you. Maybe he was somehow he was not in a what I'll say he was drunk or something like that, and on that period, on point of time, he told about you that he is in love with you, he loves you and all these things, and the divine and the karmics, you know, and the karmics from that point of time came on searching about you, what you are doing, how you look, how you carry yourself. They are peeping through your social medias. They have some of the karmics may have sent you friend requests from different account to see what you are doing, what you are exactly. They're trying to have more, gather more informations about you. And on other half, the divine masculine is preparing himself to come towards you, and they are thinking and they're very much fearful about how to confront you, because they know they have done something very bad to you. They were wearing a facade. They haven't been honest with you. They haven't been honest with their feelings that they felt towards you. And they are preparing themselves how to come towards you. They're preparing for a big surprise, but at this point of time they are very much working on their career, on their stability, so that they can give you a beautiful life, a beautiful stability, stable life, and so that you can, both can, when you are in a union, you both can be in a very strong you both can have a very strong foundation. And they're feeling very much excited. They're dreaming about a beautiful life with you, a beautiful family life with you. So divine feminines, loads and love to you. Let me see. I want to see that what I'm working on my own karmic, on twin flame decks. So I have prepared some of the decks. Let me see what your twin divine masculine wants to say. Divine feminines, collective reading for divine masculines, only for those divine feminines who are spiritually awakened, not for divine feminines, though those divine feminines who are going through dark night of the soul, only for the divine feminines who are awakened and transforming. Collective feminines for divine masculine towards divine feminine. What divine masculine wants to say is divine feminine. Archangel Michael, please come and please say what Archangel, what the collective divine masculine wants to say, the divine feminine, what the collective divine masculine wants to say, the divine feminine. Archangel Michael, okay. I'm coming very soon. To see you face to face. Please don't refuse to meet me. I hope you can see your card. Then, over here it is. I know a lot about you than you think. I always keep a close watch on you secretly. I check all your social medias without knowing you. Yes, they know about you. They know about you. First I thought, yes. You are an ordinary, simple girl, but in your separation period, I got to understand you are no ordinary girl. I thought you are a goddess to me. Yes, your divine masculine feels that you are a goddess to him. You are angel. You are a love of their life. They previously in the connection, they thought of ki you are just a simple, ordinary girl. Why should he, being such a king, should focus on a simple girl like you? But later on in the separation period, they understand what you mean to them. Actually, they are coming to see you very soon, divine feminines. They are planning to meet you face to face, and they are very much fearful about the rejection. They are telling you, please don't refuse to meet him, please. And they know a lot about you. They know a lot about you than you think. They know a lot about you. Though you people are not in communication, they are literally peeping your social medias, your divine masculines secretly. And they are gathering informations about you. They know a lot about you than you know. Let's see more masculines for the divine masculine. Let's see someone. These are my own personal created decks, guys. Channel messages. Let's see. Yes. Give me the card. I had many nightfalls being intimate with you in dream on in the dreams. Have you felt me? He's having nightfalls, guys, for you. He's safe. I told you he's giving on sexual energies towards your divine feminines. He's feeling very much sexual towards you. Yes, let's see. I am used by my karmic for money and social status. I am a money-making machine to him, to her. Yes, I told you. They are very much used by their karmics for money, for social status. Their karmic doesn't love them. They are very much about money oriented. So they are telling that divine masculine fell in love only with you, and their karmics are only using them for money. I have never been so fearful before, but now I am. I have a fear of losing you forever. Your divine masculine is very much fearful. They have never been so because they are afraid of losing you. They want you. They think that if they are going to lose you, their life is no going to have no value. So they want you very much. They love you only for love. They love you. They genuinely love you. So these are the messages from your divine masculine to divine feminines, only for those divine feminines who are transforming right now, not for those divine feminines who have just stepped into this journey are and still working. Okay, bye. Love and light to all of you. Hope to see you soon again. Please like, share, and subscribe my channel. Bye bye.